Hey guys, today I wanted to talk about baselines and how you can create it. And when I say baseline, I don't mean only the sub-bass part, I also mean the mid-range part, so the bottom and the top. And this time we are using a very unusual device, which is called DC offset. And DC offset means basically, if you look at this, when a waveform is not exactly at the zero line on the waveform, you can read it in Wikipedia if you want to know more. But this time we are using it to create bass sounds. And all you need to know is, if you're pulling this slider up, you can hear my voice is very distorted. When you pull this thing up, you're basically pulling or pushing your membrane of your monitor speakers out. And if you drag this down, you are pulling the membrane of your speaker in. So if you do this fast enough, you can create a waveform, okay? And as you know, Bitwig has many, many modulators, and you can, of course, modulate this. So we are using an LFO and dragging this down, using this, and yeah, let's modulate this. And you can hear some kind of bass. And of course we are at the end from this LFO range, which is 50 Hertz. It's not fast enough for making bass sounds, but Bitwig allows us to switch to kilohertz. So all we have to do is map this to a key of our keyboard, okay? And we do this by switching this the selector to pitch. And this allows us to track our keyboard. Oh, I have the wrong. I have no instrument track. So, switch this to pitch and track our keyboard. And of course we need an envelope to turn this off after we release the key on our keyboard. So this is also a modulator inside Bitwig, which is called ADSR. And we modulate the depth of the LFO. So let's try it again. So this is pretty nice and okay. Let's put in some little bit release. And we have a nice, sine wave. Let's put in oscillator to see what's going on. That's a nice sine wave. Okay, but we don't want to use an LFO, so we delete that. And instead I'm using an steps modulator, which allows us pitch modulation. And we can now draw in some, let's move this to 64. And this has to be the half of it, so 32. Let's draw in some waveform. And isn't of course modulated. Loud, so you can hear me. So you can basically draw in all kinds of waveforms and experiment. But our main focus is to generate as much top-end information as possible. So let's try this. Pretty unusual waveform, but okay. After the DC offset, we are trying to use one device which is called FX, Multiband FX2, which splits our frequency band in half. I'm selecting the split frequency to 100 Hertz. So we have our a container for the low information, low frequencies, and we have a container for the high frequencies. And the container for the high frequencies we are using to add distortion. So we are only applying distortion to the top end or 100 Hertz upwards. Okay, and of course we are trying to distort so it sounds nice, like a mid-range bass. And again, we are using some modulation power of Bitwig to basically make a nice and decent sound. Cabinet section. It's much cleaner. Oh, that's okay for now. I just want to show an example what you can do. Of course, you know, have different taste in styles and how a bassline should sound. Okay, so it's just some tips and examples what you can do inside Bitwig to create basslines you want, and the possibilities, of course. And okay, this is nice, and I'm trying to mute this modulator so it has no impact. And I'm creating a second one. I'm duplicating the first one and try to modulate different stuff. Maybe different speed. Okay. Okay, so we have two modulators doing nothing. Now I'm activating the first one, the second one, and yeah, I'm activating the first one. And now we can choose the select modulator, which can be used to modulate four different other modulators, maybe. So the first one is activating the first one, and the second stage is activating the second one. So now we can move between or morph between the states. Okay, let's add some more. Duplicate this. And try different settings. Maybe 6. And different wave. And duplicate this. So we have to on 300%. Maybe add some filter. After the distortion. So if I'm on stage 3, I'm adding this filter. And now can I move between all states? Yeah, maybe add some high pass just for this stage. So the last stage is basically a high pass filter just for the fun. Last stage. And one LFO for the last stage. And maybe. Okay, this is nice enough. Just add some reverb maybe. So we have still one great nice sounding sub and a separate top end, which we can distort how we like it. And yeah, you can see just adding some modulators to different random parameters inside the distortion effect or filters can lead to nice moving sounds. And if you combine everything with the switch to morph between the modulators, you can have already so much movement inside your bassline without resampling or other kinds of annoying steps. And you have so much control over everything, it's basically insane. And of course you can still modulate the first sound source. It's impossible to show every possible step inside this small chain. So I hope I gave you some nice inspiration for your own devices. And yeah, try it out and have fun with it. So that's it for the day, basically. If you have some questions about this tutorial, you can leave me always a comment or write me some direct messages on here on YouTube or on Facebook. I try to answer them all. So I hope you learned something. If you do, then please leave me a like or subscribe to the channel, and we will see each other on the next tutorials. Bye.